मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस नविदा शेख फ्रॉम बृहन मुंबई महानगर पालिका MCGM वर्चुअल क्लास. आई वेलकम ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स टू अनदर एन इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन. इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी लर्निंग समथिंग न्यू एंड इंटरेस्टिंग फ्रॉम अ साइंस टेक्स्ट बुक. सो लेट्स गेट.
Good morning, dear students. I am Mrs. Navida Sheikh from MCGM Virtual Class. I welcome all my dear students to another and interesting session. In today's class, we'll be learning a very interesting chapter from your science textbook, that is Disaster Management. Now, this is the very first part of the chapter that we are starting with, and we will be discussing about the basic knowledge about what is the meaning of disaster, what is disaster management and all. Okay, so let's get started. In our previous standards also, we have learned about what is disaster. Disaster is very simple to understand. You must have seen in news channels and on radios, you must have heard about disasters happening here and there all over the world. Now, the disruption on a massive scale, either natural or man-made, occurring in short or long period is termed as disaster. Disaster management in India has been an important point of discussion owing to frequent natural disasters ranging from earthquakes, floods, drought, etc. Now, disaster means any type of calamity that occurs on a large scale and it affects so many people around, that is a disaster. It could be naturally or it could be man-made. Now, we have learned about the difference between the man-made disaster and naturally occurring disasters in our previous standards. Okay, I'll be giving you all a few examples of both the types, and that will help you to clear out what is the meaning of natural disaster and man-made disaster. Now, first let us understand about the meaning of the word disaster. A disaster is defined as a disruption on a massive scale, either naturally or man-made, occurring in short or long periods. Now, disaster could be a short period type of thing, like an earthquake. Okay, it occurs only for a few seconds or few minutes. Okay, but it could have a very long-term effect on that surrounding, or it could be a long-term occurring disaster. Okay, so like tsunami. In tsunami, it is a very long disaster which takes place with starting as an earthquake. After an earthquake, there's a huge wave of water which comes into the cities and it causes huge amount of loss. Okay, so that could come under a long-term disaster as well. So the disasters can lead to human, material, economic or environmental hardships which can be beyond the bearable capacity of the affected society. As per statistics, India as a whole is vulnerable to 30 different types of disasters. Means India ke andar there are chances that we can have more than 30 different types of disasters. Okay, that can affect the economic, social and human development potential to such an extent that it will have long-term effects of productivity and macroeconomic performance. Means हमारी जो इकोनॉमी है, पैसे के ऊपर भी इफेक्ट करता है डिजास्टर्स के वजह से, और हमारी हेल्थ के ऊपर, सोसाइटी में जो लोग रह रहे हैं उनके ऊपर, हर तरीके से डिजास्टर उस पर्टिकुलर एरिया को या फिर उस पर्टिकुलर कंट्री को इफेक्ट करता है. ठीक है, सो डिजास्टर मीन्स दैट एनी अकरेंस दैट कॉजेज डैमेज, इकोलॉजिकल डिसरप्शन, लॉस ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ or deterioration of health and health services on a scale sufficient to warrant an extraordinary response from outside the affected community or area. Okay, this is the meaning given by the WHO in 1995 of the word disaster. ठीक है, तो हमारी ह्यूमन लॉस होता है, इकोलॉजिकल डिस्ट्रप्शन मीन्स जो हमारा एनवायरमेंट है, प्लांट्स है, एनिमल्स है, जो हमारा इकोसिस्टम है, अगर उसके अंदर कुछ डिस्ट्रप्शन होता है जो डैमेज कॉज करता है हमारी हेल्थ को या हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज को या हमारी इकोनॉमी को, उसे हम लोग डिजास्टर कहते हैं. नाउ दीज आर अ फ्यू एग्जांपल्स ऑफ डिजास्टर्स लाइक अ टोर्नेडो, वॉल्केनो, अर्थक्वेक, सुनामी, फॉरेस्ट फायर, डस्ट स्टॉर्म्स, एवलांच, ड्रॉट, थंडरस्टॉर्म, हेल स्टॉर्म, स्नो स्टॉर्म, फ्लड, हरिकेन, सैंडस्टॉर्म, sinkhole or windstorm. So these are all different types of disasters that you must have seen also on television or in movies or in the newspapers or heard about them. Okay? Like a tornado, it is a huge wind which carries even in certain cities, not in India mostly, but abroad. There are huge cars or houses which are carried away by that wind. It is so violent and it is so destructive. Volcano, हम लोग सब पढ़ चुके हैं volcano के बारे में कि किस तरीके से ये naturally lava जो होता है हमारे earth के अंदर वो burst out होता है from the mountains and which again causes a loss, lot of loss of the human life also and the environment as well. Earthquake, जो shake movement, trembling of the earth, that is earthquake. Tsunami also India has faced about this type of disaster as well. Drought, जहाँ पर सूखा पड़ जाता है. Thunderstorm, जब lightning strike करती है हमारे earth को, उसकी वजह से भी बहुत नुकसान होता है जहाँ पर भी lightning गिरती है. Hailstorm, बड़े बड़े जब बर्फ के टुकड़े गिरते हैं, not snow, okay, बड़े बड़े ice के टुकड़े गिरते हैं, तो उससे भी बहुत तरीके के problems और it affects the humans and the birds around and animals around. Flood also you have seen in India many a times. We have experienced about flood also. Recently you also have learned and heard about the different floods that occurred in India. Sandstorm, जब बहुत सारी धूल उड़ती है and it is not ऐसे सादी सी धूल उड़ना. Sand, जहाँ पर भी desert होते हैं वहाँ पर ये sandstorm होते हैं. Okay, so these are all types of disasters which can last for a very long time, especially forest fire. जब जंगल में आग लगती है तो ये बहुत दूर तक फैलती है because you have wood all around that forest, right? And dried leaf which catch fire very easily. So these are all examples of disasters. Now disasters could be of two types, man-made disasters and natural disasters. In man-made disasters, we can talk about the atomic bombs, okay, which were led by during the World War and about the Hiroshima and Nagasaki, you must have heard about or read about that when the atom bombs were placed and because of that huge amount of loss had occurred in that particular area. Aaj bhi wahan par jo bachche hote hain, so they are also, they do not have, they are genetically, they do not have proper genetic disorders are there in them, okay, and they do not have a healthy lifestyle like us, which people have been affected because of that nuclear bomb, okay. After that, then the disasters like attacks like 9/11, okay, जहाँ पर टेररिस्ट लोग अटैक करते हैं पर्टिकुलर एरिया को, वहाँ पर ह्यूमन लॉस होता है, इकोनॉमिकल लॉस होता है. दीज आर ऑल टाइप ऑफ डिजास्टर्स दैट कुड अकर. राइड्स जब होते हैं तो उसमें भी एक तरीके का, उसे भी एक तरीके का डिजास्टर कहा जाता है, ठीक है. आफ्टर दैट नेचुरल डिजास्टर्स आर लाइक वाइल्ड फायर, अर्थक्वेक, ड्रॉट, फ्लडिंग. दीज आर ऑल कमिंग अंडर नेचुरल डिजास्टर. आई होप दिस मच इज क्लियर. What is the difference between man-made disaster and natural disaster? So let us come to the meaning of the word disaster management. We have the chapter's name is disaster management, so we should know what is disaster management. As per the Disaster Management Act of 2005, it defines disaster management as an integrated process of planning, organizing, coordinating and implementing measures which are necessary for prevention of threat of any disaster. Agar suppose hum logo ko pata chal jata hai ki yahan par disaster hone wala hai, to use prevent kaise kiya ja sakta hai, theek hai. Suppose agar kisi tarike ka, agar suppose there is a there is a fight between two countries, okay, so that could also lead to any kind of a disaster. It could lead to any kind of a disaster over there also. So if it could be prevented, then the two committees sit down, they talk about it and they try to prevent that, okay. Or agar there are different further reasons, reduction of risk of any disaster or its consequences. Aajkal aise schemes banai ja rahi hai taki jahan par agar डिजास्टर होने का रिस्क है तो उसे रिड्यूस किया जाता है, वहाँ पर कम से कम नुकसान हो ऐसी चीजें बनाई जाती है। रेडीनेस टू डील विद एनी डिजास्टर, अगर सपोज डिजास्टर होता है किसी भी तरीके का तो उसे किस तरीके से डील करना, उसे किस तरीके से लोगों की हेल्प करना, वो सारी चीजें डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट में आती है। प्रॉम्प्टनेस इन डीलिंग विद अ डिजास्टर, असेसिंग द सिवियरिटी ऑफ द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ एनी डिजास्टर, रेस्क्यू एंड रिलीफ, अगर कुछ हो रहा है तो किस तरीके से लोगों को वहां से निकाला जाए, किस तरीके से उन्हें खाना पहुंचाया जाए या शेल्टर पहुंचाया जाए, रिहैबिलिटेशन एंड रिकंस्ट्रक्शन, सपोज अगर किसी तरीके के डिजास्टर में कोई पूरी तरीके से चीजें डिमोल खत्म हो गई है, टूट गई है, सो अगेन दोज पीपल नीड प्रॉपर हाउस एंड फैसिलिटीज, तो उसे वापस से रिकंस्ट्रक्ट करना, लोगों को वापस से वहां पर रिहैबिलिटेट करना, ओके, दिस ऑल कम्स अंडर डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट। लेट्स कम ऑन टू द मीनिंग ऑफ फैमिन्स। फैमिन, द लिटरल मीनिंग ऑफ फैमिन इज एक्सट्रीमली इनएडिक्वेंसी एंड स्केसिटी ऑफ फूड, जब बिल्कुल भी पानी नहीं होता है बहुत लंबे टाइम के लिए और खाना नहीं होता है, ठीक है, और बहुत कम अमाउंट में खाना प्रेजेंट होता है, तो वो जगह पर उसे कहते हैं फैमिन होना। फैमिन इज फिनोमिनन विच अकर्स इन अ वास्ट टेरेस्ट्रियल एरिया ड्यू टू वेरियस एनवायरमेंटल एंड बायोलॉजिकल रीजंस, इट कुड बी बिकॉज ऑफ वेरियस रीजन, ठीक है, जरूरी नहीं है कि पानी, बारिश नहीं हो रही है इसीलिए नहीं हो रहा है, कभी कभार गवर्नमेंट की फैसिलिटीज इतनी सही नहीं होती है जिसकी वजह से पानी सप्लाई किया जा सके, उस वजह से भी होती है, पॉलिटिकल प्रेशर्स होते हैं उसकी वजह से भी होता है, एक पर्टिकुलर रीजन को पानी नहीं दिया जाता है, खाना नहीं दिया जाता है, ओके, दैट कुड ऑल्सो कॉज वन ऑफ द रीजन ऑफ फैमिन्स इन अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया। सम ऑफ द प्राइम रीजन्स आर पॉपुलेशन इम्बैलेंस, स्केसिटी ऑफ वाटर और लैक ऑफ रेनफॉल, पॉपुलेशन इम्बैलेंस, क्रॉप फेलियर, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसीज, दीज आर ऑल रीजन्स ऑफ फैमिन्स इन अ पर्टिकुलर रीजन, ठीक है, अगर पॉपुलेशन ज़्यादा होती जा रही है तो ऑब्वियस सी बात है वो एक पर्टिकुलर रीजन में खाना कम होगा, वहाँ पे पानी की भी ज़रूरतें ज़्यादा हैं और वहाँ पर अगर सही तरीके से पानी नहीं पहुँच रहा है देन देयर विल बी स्केसिटी ऑफ वाटर एज वेल, अगर क्रॉप्स नहीं होते हैं सही तरीके से तो दैट ऑल्सो लीड्स टू फैमिन, ओके, एंड गवर्नमेंट की जो पॉलिसीज होती है कभी कभार वो फार्मर्स के हक में नहीं होती है, उस वजह से भी फैमिन्स होते हैं। ऑलराइट, सो आई होप इट इज क्लियर नाउ। लेट अस लर्न मोर अबाउट फैमिन्स इन इंडिया। फैमिन इन इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट इज अ क्रॉनिकल फीचर, मीन्स बहुत बार हो चुका है ये और होता रहता है। एग्रीकल्चर इन इंडिया इज हैवीली डिपेंडेंट ऑन अ सूटेबल क्लाइमेट, हमारे यहाँ का जो क्लाइमेट है, ठीक है, तो उस वजह से एग्रीकल्चर इज़ वेरी फेवरेबल, और अगर ये क्लाइमेट सही तरीके से नहीं मेंटेन होता, हमारे यहाँ पर रेनफॉल्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल द क्रॉप्स, राइट, सो रेन्स इन समर आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द इरीगेशन ऑफ क्रॉप्स, एंड इफ देर इज अ लैक ऑफ रेनफॉल एंड ड्रॉट्स हैड लेड टू सेवरल फैमिन्स इन इंडिया बिटवीन द 11th एंड द 17th सेंचुरी सेवियरली, ओके, These famines caused a widespread scarcity of food and were responsible for numerous deaths across the country. The most significant famine in this list are the Great Bengal Famine of 1770, caused around 10 million deaths. Skull Famine or Doji Bara Famine caused 11 million deaths and Chalisa Famine which also caused 11 million deaths approximately. So you can imagine how many people have died because of the scarcity of food and water. Okay, in this picture you can see how these people actually look. They do not have any type of muscles. They only have bones and skin over their body because of the lack of food and water. Now let us understand about the causes of famines. Now there are two types of causes, natural causes and man-made reasons. Natural causes could be flood, cyclone, storm, जिसकी वजह से crops खराब हो जाते हैं, ठीक है, और या फिर drought, यहाँ पर अगर बारिश नहीं होती है तो भी famines होते हैं, earthquake जिसके वजह से again land gets damaged, droughts cause extreme scarcity of water and thus results in crop failure, on the other hand flood and earthquakes can destroy crops or food storage places, these all result in food scarcity and eventually famines. Next, you have man-made reasons. lack of food due to no crop failure or no storage of food. ठीक है, कभी कभार गवर्नमेंट की जो पॉलिसीज होती है या फिर कभी कभार सही तरीके से स्टोरेज फैसिलिटीज नहीं प्रोवाइड की जाती है फार्मर्स को, तो उसकी वजह से भी लैक ऑफ फूड होता है. नो प्रॉपर फूड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इन सर्टन रीजन्स, कंजम्पशन ऑफ कंटामिनेटेड वाटर एंड एयर. सपोज अगर वहाँ पर फैमिन है तो वहाँ पर अगर पानी और एयर अच्छी नहीं होगी, ऑब्वियस सी बात है, क्रॉप्स इरीगेशन इम्पॉसिबल इन सच सिचुएशन. There are various famines that were man-made. Grabbing lands, wars, and improper administration were the main reason for many of the famines in recent history. Okay, so taking away farmers' lands or not providing proper administration about how the crops are grown and how they need to be sold in the market, all these things have led to scarcity of food and water in that particular region. Okay, so these are a few causes of famines that we need to know. Let us understand about the effects of famine. Now here in this picture you can see how famine has affected animals, plants and humans. Starvation is nothing but the biological consequences of a continuous scarcity of food. Starvation matlab bhook. ठीक है, जब हम लोग किसी भी तरीके से खाना या पानी नहीं मिलती, means हम लोग starve कर रहे हैं. During the famine, starvation occurs on a mass scale, means बहुत सारे लोग starve करते हैं, even animals and plants. Various diseases also occur in the human body during famine like cholera. It is caused by bacteria, vibrio cholerae, which leads to an increased amount of water to be released from cells that line the intestine. Symptoms include watery diarrhea, abdominal cramps, dry mucous membrane, mouth and skin, excessive thirst and lethargy. So, because of famines, people tend to eat and drink water, whatever water they get, okay? तो वो साफ पानी नहीं रहता, वो गंदा ही पानी रहता है, उसके अंदर bacterias होता है, और वो पीने से, पानी पीने से, वो खाना खाने से, again the people suffer from various type of diseases. Dropsy, which is now referred as oedema, is caused due to excessive fluid under the skin. The body swells, the affected area often retains a dimple after being pressed for a few seconds. मतलब अगर सूजन लगती है वहाँ पर, अगर हम लोग दबाएंगे तो वो skin अंदर चली जाती है. ठीक है, so this is also caused because of famines. Dysentery is another bacterial disease which spreads through water, stools and food. Poor sanitization, contaminated food and water and crowded living conditions lead to dysentery. Symptoms include blood in the stool, abdominal pain, diarrhea and fever. Another notable condition is anemia. There can be a lot more diseases that are caused due to famines. Apart from diseases, famine also causes low fertility rates, poor living conditions, fewer income options, various social, political issues, etc. So apart from health issues, there are various other things which are affecting the humans who are living in famine. So it is a kind of disaster that we all need to know about, and we should know what are the effects of it and how people get affected because of famines. Let us see how we can prevent famine. Since famine is majorly caused due to natural reasons, it is difficult to prevent it. However, there are certain ways of controlling the effects of famine. There should be surplus agricultural production beyond the requirements of the rural population. The transportation system should be well developed between rural and urban areas. There should be proper health care, clean drinking water and sanitization. You should plant more trees in order to attract rainfall. And to prevent famines, we should see to it that all these things have been followed and done properly. Let us see one more natural disaster, that is cloudburst. Now, as the word suggests, cloudburst means there will be a cloud and it will burst. Now, what exactly happens and how does this happen? Let us have a look at that. Now, we have all learnt about how evaporation takes place and how clouds are formed, right? With the help of water cycle, we have seen that the water evaporates. This evaporated water vapor goes up and they condense and they form clouds. Now when these clouds, they become heavy, they give out rainwater, right? Raindrops. But during a cloud burst, now this water vapors are filled in with the, there are heavy clouds filled with water and they are overloaded with water and they cannot hold on to the amount of water that is there. And what it leads to is the bursting of the clouds. So you can see the difference between rain and a cloud burst. ठीक है, रेन के अंदर यू कैन सी वॉटर ड्रॉपलेट्स कमिंग डाउन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रेन एंड व्हेन यू सी अ क्लाउड बर्स्ट यू कैन सी दैट देयर इज एक्चुअली अ क्लाउड व्हिच हैज बर्स्ट फ्रॉम द सेंटर एंड यू कैन सी ऑल द वॉटर व्हिच इज देयर इन दैट क्लाउड इज पोरिंग डाउन ओके लाइक अ फाउंटेन. सो देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन रेन एंड क्लाउड बर्स्ट एंड क्लाउड बर्स्ट इज मोर डेंजरस बिकॉज यू हैव मोर अमाउंट ऑफ वॉटर कमिंग डाउन ऑन टू यू in a large amount and in a very small period of time. Okay, so flooding can occur and many people can die because of that. Sometimes the water coming down from the rain clouds does not reach the land in the form of rain. Instead, due to very high temperature near the land, it vaporizes and goes back into the same cloud. Okay, as a result, the amount of vapor in those clouds become very high. Due to rapid condensation, it rains suddenly over a specific and small region at a rate of 100 mm per hour or more. This is known as cloud burst. So you can imagine how dangerous it is. Because of that condition going on again and again, एक particular cloud के ऊपर इतना load पड़ जाता है कि वो vapors को hold नहीं कर पाता और वो burst open होता है and then it leads to एक particular specific region पे ही इतना सारा पानी गिरने लगता है. So that is known as cloudburst. A cloudburst occurred at Leh, or that is in Ladakh, on 6th August 2010. The cloudburst that occurred in Mumbai on 26th August 2005 was extraordinary and unforgettable. We've all learnt about this. We've all read about this. We all were very young when this took place. So you can go through the internet and see this. Now these are a few images. You can see a bus fully drowned in water. Now this is on the road, so you can see the amount of water that had accumulated because of that rain, and that was a cloud burst that happened. You can see people walking on the street, how they are walking on the street. You can see the buses, there were boats in order to rescue people in the regions where there was too much of water accumulated. Trains had halted. You can see the amount, how the people are walking, how much amount of water was filled in the railway tracks. Okay, so this is how the cloudburst can affect that particular area. On that day, it rained about 950 mm, that is 37 inches in 8 to 10 hours, and the entire city of Mumbai was over waterlogged and flooded. Okay, so these were the effects of a cloudburst in Mumbai in 2005. Now this could happen because of a cloud burst also. You can imagine how people lose their belongings, their cars, their vehicles, even their buildings. They break and they are washed along with the water. The high amount of the intensity of water flowing is very high. Okay, and that could even wash out the houses that are near the river banks if that particular region is affected by cloud burst. Okay. So you can imagine how dangerous cloudburst could be. So I hope with this part of the chapter is quite clear to all of you. In this chapter, in this period, we have talked about two types of disasters. We have learnt about famines and we have learnt about cloudburst. In the next coming period, we will be learning more about this chapter and few more disasters. How can we prevent them and what are the reasons of it? So please see to it that you go through the video once again. If you have any doubts and difficulties, you can ask us in the comment section below. Till then, thank you. If you like the session, please do not forget to subscribe to our channel so that you can share and
this session was quite useful to you. In the next coming period, we'll learn something new and interesting. Till then, thank you.